Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding Straws in the Paris Wind, written by Happimon Jacob. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is very important for political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the response, the knee-jerk response that the France is giving to this debilitating act of terrorism. This editorial is also about to look for the righteousness and the justifiability of what France is doing. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we need to know the ideology of terrorism. We need to understand what is meant by terrorism. And we need to also understand what the world is doing in order to curtail this terrorism. Now, 9/11 is one such date that reminds us of the starkness in the polarization that has engulfed the entire world. 9/11 is one such date that has put the Muslim world against the English world. 9/11 is one such date that has caused the attrition, that has caused the antagonism, that has caused the war, that has caused the misery, the pain to the entire world. Now, the response to 9/11 by the United States of America, it was a knee-jerk response. The knee-jerk response that the United States of America has given to the countries like Iraq, Iran, Afghanistan, Syria, Libya, Lebanon, etc., it is beginning to backlash to the entire European Union and to the English world. Now, had the action by the United States of America after 9/11 would have been a bit more pragmatic, it would not have been facing what it is facing now. So, what should be the actual action of the countries who are facing this tyranny of terrorism? The foremost thing that the countries need to understand is that the irrational response, less than a pragmatic response, knee-jerk response is not going to work. These knee-jerk responses will lead to further polarization. These knee-jerk responses will lead to further isolation. These knee-jerk responses will make the life of the minorities more difficult. Now, this is what is happening in France. So, what should be the solution like? The solution is to define what is meant by terrorism. Till now, the world has not been able to define terrorism. And then the world has not been able to pinpoint who is a terrorist. Now, these two things needs to be worked out, and we need to move forward in the direction of coming up with comprehensive anti-terrorism convention. Now, this convention is lying pending in the United Nations. Now, terrorism is something that has become globalized. Terrorism is something that has spread its tentacles on the entire world. Now, if you want to tackle this menace, you need a comprehensive terrorist convention by which we can fight out this menace. And how can that be done? Define terrorism, look out for the groups that are spreading this terrorism, then look out for their sources of finances, look out what is motivating them, then curtailing their sources of motivation, curtailing their sources of finances, then if their demands are legitimate, justifiable, just try to placate those demands, try to fulfill those demands. This is how we can tackle this menace of terrorism. By knee-jerk responses, by not allowing the refugees to come into your country, by restricting your borders, you will be in a big misery, the economic misery, the misery of isolation, the misery of a vacuum. So the world requires a comprehensive terrorism convention. But why have we not been able to have this convention till now? The difference of the approaches existing in the world among the big superpowers is a big cause of why we have been belied of such a convention. Now, what the United States of America treat as a terrorism is treated as a national movement, a movement of freedom by the one who is propagating this terrorism. We don't have a benchmark, we don't have a standard to define an act of a terrorist. We don't have a yardstick to measure what is terrorism and what is a freedom movement, what is a movement of emancipation, what is a movement of an empowerment. So we need to be more ethical. We also need to come out with global ethical treaty. We also need to come out with global peace treaty. So focusing only on the comprehensive anti-terrorism convention will not work. Along with that, we need other instruments. Yesterday's editorial, Shiv Vishwanathan, he was talking about how the world is devoid of the peace treaty. We are not talking about peace. We are talking only about war. And this war is embedded in the human nature. So we need to come out with something that can engender peace. We need to come out with something that can sustain the world global order as per the morals and the ethics. And we need not to aberrate. We need not to veer away from this ethics. So three things: comprehensive treaty we need peace treaty, and then we need to work as per the ethics and as per the peace. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes and entire civil services preparation. And in order to avail the information of the classes that we are offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and briniki.com. And you can also contact me at 84594000 in case you have any sort of query about the preparation of civil services. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Briniki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And please do participate in the answer writing program. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.